गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल। Yes, am I well now? Not clearly. Okay, tell me what we were doing in the last. Basicity of amines. Amines, right? Clearly audible. What I am writing, is it? Yes. Is it visible to all of you? What I am writing. Yes. Very good. Okay. So basicity of amines. In amines, we did the basicity of aliphatic amines, in which we find that in gaseous or in gaseous state. Sorry. In gaseous or non-aqueous. The order is tertiary amines are more basic than secondary, then primary, then ammonia. This order is due to the presence of plus I effect. This is due to the plus I effect only, right? And in case of aqueous solution, is there due to stable then solvation effect. It is not. Wait, I'm reloading the session. Wait. Right now audible, clearly audible? Okay, so see, now what is the basicity of this? Was due to the inductive effect, extent of hydrogen bonding, steric effect of the alkyl groups, right? And now the basicity of ara alkynes. In case of ara aliphatic, means mixed ara alkyl amines, in which due to electron withdrawing inductive effect, the aryl group, this is having the more pKb value. More pKb value means okay, aryl is done. Aryl also done. Right, very good. Then simple aromatic amines, basicity of aromatic. Done, basicity of aromatic. Okay. Then after that, basicity of aromatic, effect of substituents on aromatic ring. Effect of substituents. No. Okay. So we'll start with the effect of substituents. Right. So see, effects of substituent on aromatic ring. Okay. Effect of substituents. See, this we have the aromatic ring with amine, right? And there are two types of substituents that are attached with it, either electron withdrawing group or electron releasing group, right? These two types of groups may be present, electron withdrawing or electron releasing group. If electron withdrawing group is there, then suppose this is electron withdrawing group and we have this amine, then what happen if electron withdrawing group is there? Not clearly visible? I thought it is more visible to you. Color change. Okay. Background color. Is it okay? This color is okay. Okay, I choose this Microsoft board so that it will be visible more. It is more smooth, that's why. And more number of features are there, means we can I can use eraser to erase one or two things only. Okay. So if it is not comfortable, then tell me. I'll change. Thank you, Aryan. See, in case what we did, it is basic if it donates these two lone pairs. Okay, we are only talking about these lone pairs. Right? If it donates these lone pairs, then it will be basic in nature. It will be basic in nature. Otherwise, if these lone pairs, they become busy in other aromatic character, okay, then it will be less basic, right? Then the basicity will decrease, right? So we have this aromatic ring, this aryl ring. This is already electron withdrawing in nature, okay? It is electron withdrawing in nature. So it attracts lone pair in the resonance. Okay, the lone pair get busy in the resonance, but this will add the effect. If the electron withdrawing group is attached, then this will add the effect. It will attract more towards it. Okay, and it becomes less basic. Right? And if electron releasing group is there, if electron releasing group is there, in this case, take methoxy group, okay, it is electron releasing, then it compensates the requirement of aryl group, electron withdrawing nature of the aryl group. It also compensates this, okay. So these electrons, these two lone pair of electron, this is now more available than simple aromatic amine. It is more available than simple aromatic amine due to the presence of electron releasing group. This is electron releasing group, right? Clear this thing? Okay, and there is also effect of, if we take means one thing is there, effect of number of substituents also. Effect of number of substituents is there. If more number of substituents are there, then more will be the effect. Either it is positive or negative. Means either it is electron withdrawing or electron releasing. If less number of substituents are there, so here one group is there. Okay, one nitro group is there. If two nitro groups are there, then it will be less basic. If three nitro groups are there, then it will be less basic. Okay, and here one electron releasing group is there, then it will be more basic than the simple one. And if two or three releasing groups are there, then it will be more basic. Okay, effect of number of substituents is also there. And second thing is effect of the position of the substituents. Position of substituents. Right, what will be the position of the substituent? So tell me, at what position the effect is more? See here, para position. Very good. See here, what happens means the electron density is either taken by the electron withdrawing group or released by the electron releasing group. These two things are happening. Okay, electron density, if the groups are present at a para position, then it can directly take the electron density from that carbon where it is located, means from this carbon. If you draw the resonating structure, then you will clearly it will be visible that from this carbon it will take the electron density. And if electron releasing group is there, that on that carbon it will provide the electron density. And here from that carbon, see, from that carbon it will take the electron density. directly on which it is attached. Okay, so the effect is more on the para position. If the substituent is at para position, then effect will be more. Tell me, is this thing is clear? Effect of substituent, it depends on two things: nature of the means position of the substituent and number of the substituents. Right? Okay. We'll see that this thing. We have the aniline. Okay. Two. One thing is that if the electrons are involved in the resonance. Okay, electrons are involved in resonance, then how many structure it will make? This will NH2 positive means one more structure. Okay, one more structure, one more structure means five structures are there. Okay, but if it will act as if these two electron pair, if these two electrons, it will act as a base and attract a proton, then it will become this is the anilinium ion. Anilinium ion, right? Now this ion is there. See, what will be the resonating structure of this? Only benzene resonance is there. These are the two resonating structures. Only these two resonating structures are there. Yes. Yes. So in these two resonating structures are there. So which will be more stable? That is stabilized by five resonating structure. So by this way, we can say that aromatic acids, they are far less basic than aliphatic or ammonium. Okay, due to the presence of what? Five resonating structures. Resonance. Yes, very good. Due to the presence of resonance. Okay. So effect is also done. Electron withdrawing and electron releasing position is also done. Then, okay. Then the chemical properties of amines. Okay. In case the chemical properties, first thing is the basic character. So we all know that amines are basic in nature and aliphatic amines are more basic than ammonia and then aromatic amines. Okay, so first is the reaction with water. See, due to the presence of lone pair on electron, nitrogen atom and amines, they are stronger bases than water. Yes or no? They are stronger bases than water or not? They are stronger bases than water or not? See, amines are like this. Okay, whatever the type of amine is there, and water is this one. Which one is more basic? See, this is having two lone pair, but the electronegativity is more. Okay, due to more electronegativity, it will not ready to donate its lone pair. So it is basic. Okay, due to less electronegativity, electronegativity value is lower. Due to less electronegativity, it is more basic than water. Okay, and if we do the reaction of amine, any type of amine with water, then what will happen? Reaction with water. Yes, release of OH. How it will release OH? See, first RNH2, take this amine, okay? When it will react with water, HOH, partial positive, partial negative, then it will give this type of ion, NH, okay? This lone pair will attach with, or directly it will attach with H positive of water and OH negative. Okay, so NH2, we can represent it as, this is positive, this is negative. We can represent it as RNH3OH negative. This is, so it becomes, what is the name of this? Alkyl ammonium hydroxide. It is alkyl ammonium hydroxide. Okay, then it break to RNH3 plus OH negative. It will release OH negative ions in the water. That's why in aqueous solution they are basic in nature, and this will become a conjugate acid. Remember this. It will become a conjugate acid, right? So due to the formation of hydroxide ions, the aqueous solutions of amines, they are basic in nature, right? So this can be detected by precipitation of metal hydroxide such as aluminium hydroxide. You must study about the glutinous white PPT of ferric oxide. Ferric oxide gives the brown PPT like this. If means in this reaction, how we can detect that amine is present in water? The solution of this amine, okay? The solution is basic. Some basic solution is given to you, suppose. Okay, the solution is basic. You can identify the basic solution from the pH, right? To test pH paper. By pH paper, you can identify. Then how you will identify that the solution is basic only due to the presence of amines. Okay, this will be identified by treating it with the reagents like aluminium chloride and ferric chloride. Okay, then it will give the precipitation into aluminium hydroxide and ferric hydroxide. Okay, it will give white precipitates. Okay, glutinous white precipitate, and it will give brown precipitate. Then by these reagents, we can identify that amines are present. Okay. Next is the reaction with acids. How amines react with acids? Reactions with acid. See, amines are very basic in nature. Acid plus base, what it gives? Acid plus base gives salt plus water. Right? So acid is, take any acid, bases are amine, RNH2, it will take H positive. Then here is a removal of RNH2, H plus. This is the ammonium. How it will become salt? With chlorine, ammonium salt. Right? Alkyl ammonium. Okay, and if it is reacting with the H2SO4, then it will give alkyl ammonium sulfate. If it is reacting with HNO3, then it will give alkyl ammonium nitrate. Can you do these reactions? RNH2, if reacting with H2SO4, then two H positives are there, so two moles are required for this. Okay. One will take one, one will take one. Then RNH3 positive, 2SO4 2 negative, right? And if RNH2 it is reacting with nitric acid HNO3, then it will dissociate as H positive NO3 negative nitrate. Then it will give RNH3 positive NO3 negative. This is alkyl ammonium nitrate. This is alkyl ammonium, dialkyl ammonium. Ammonium sulfate. Right? Clear? HSO3, yes, very good. So now also voice is breaking. Is it audible clearly? Okay. Right. Next is reaction with metal ions. How they will react with metal ions? See, ammonia amines, they form the soluble coordination complexes with the transition metals such as silver, copper ions. Okay, the silver chlorides dissolve in methylamine solution due to the formation of soluble complex. So what is the soluble complex? See, now the reaction with metals. Okay, so if it is RNH2, then it will form the soluble complex with, or take it as the methylamine solution, CH3NH2. Okay, methylamine solution, then it will form methylamine, this type of solution. Wait, 2 moles are required. Then AG NH2, right? Cl negative. Okay, so this is the name of this is bismethylamine silver chloride. Okay. It will be clearly shown as taken by this. Okay. in this side also the bond is this one. Bis methyl amine. Bismethylamine, silver, 1 chloride. Okay, this is the action with metals. Okay, next one is alkylation of amines. See, both the aliphatic and aromatic primary, secondary and tertiary amines, these react with alkyl halides to form secondary, tertiary and quaternary ammonium salts. Alkyl halides means so it is very simple method to convert lower alkene to higher alkene, lower amines to higher amines also. This reaction with alkyl halides or alkylation, we take alkylation, then it is, if it is treated with RnH2, suppose primary, it is treated with alkyl halide, then what will happen? See, RnH, H2 will Rx, X is removed. So, RnRh plus HX. Right. Further, if it is treated with Rx, then again it will remove as minus HX. It will be R2N secondary, then HX. Okay, plus HX, whatever. And here, if it is further treated with Rx, then R3N positive, right, with removal of X negative, or we can write it as R3N positive and X negative. This is the quaternary ammonium ion. And it is the one of the best method to convert lower amines to higher amines. Yes. Understood? Which is the process of converting an amine, converting any type of amine to the quaternary ammonium salt on treatment with excess of alkyl halide. This is called exhaustic alkylation. Okay, if the alkyl halide used is methyl iodide, or commonly methyl group is used. If the alkyl halide is used as methyl iodide or any exhaustic methylation. Okay, very important reaction. What is the reaction? What is the reaction? Not there is a network problem. Wait, I'm again reloading once again. Okay. Yes, now tell me, is it audible now? Audible? Okay, what I am saying is, if the alkylation takes place, okay, the reaction in which there is conversion of any alkyl amine, okay, conversion of alkyl amine, either primary, secondary, or tertiary, it is converted to quaternary salt. Okay, and instead, if we are using alkyl, okay, instead we are using methyl iodide, especially methyl iodide, then it is known as exhaustive methylation. Then it is known as exhaustive methylation. Very important reaction, exhaustive methylation. Clear? Okay, next one is acylation. Acylation is a type of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, acylation. And acylation is done by reagent acyl chloride or acetic anhydride. Okay, or acetic anhydride. This one or acyl chloride, right? If we take NH2, just take RNH2 primary with acyl chloride, right? Then it will go and act RNH. Right, C double bond O CH3. Right, this is acylation. Okay. By acyl chloride. So N substituted amide is formed. Yes or no? Yes, only clear to her Komal, right? So if instead of this, if we take aniline, then we get NHCOCH3. Okay, this reaction is taken place in the presence of pyridine, right? And aniline plus acetyl chloride. Okay, primary amine plus acetyl chloride. And if we take aniline plus CCl benzoyl chloride, this one. Okay, then same reaction takes place, will released and this NH CO, this product is formed. Yes or no? This product is formed. What is the name of this? This is, just see fast, benzenalide. And this reaction is known as Schotten-Baumann reaction. This is known as Baumann reaction. Okay, it is a naming reaction, right? Yes or no? These are the chemical properties of amine, or 2-3 chemical properties are left, then amines are completed. And one more topic is there, that is amines react as a phase transfer catalyst. Okay, then your unit 1 is completed, right? So one more lecture is required, and after this lecture I will open the portals for assignment, and according to this assignment and quiz. Okay, previous page, I think it is cleared. It is cleared. Where is the doubt, Lavisha? I will clear. Where is the doubt? Tell me. I'll write the reactions that were written in the previous page. Okay? See. Only two reactions were in. One is with this one. Yes, acylation ke baad. Okay, so that was the acylation only. Acylation we are doing only. CC, CH3, it will come back again, and CH3. This reaction, this is with aniline and acetyl chloride. Okay, and RnH2 plus acyl chloride. These all three reactions are of acylation by taking different type of amines. Okay, RnH double bond CH3. Okay, these two reactions we were discussed, right? Now, thank you so much. Thank you.